In this video, I want to show how to simplify algebraic expressions involving radicals, but notice that I'm looking at specifically odd exponents this time. It says when the exponent is odd that the resulting expression or answer is going to be a mixed radical this time of the form x to the power of n root x. Now before I start the odd exponent examples, I want to just take a quick recap of the even exponent examples for a second. So let's just think back to the even exponents. We said that we can rewrite the square root of an expression as that expression to the power of 1/2. And when we have an even exponent, multiplying by 1/2 is very easy. 4 times 1/2 is 2. Here, 6 times 1/2 is 3. So essentially, we use this rule when we are simplifying odd exponents. Let's look at a couple of examples. If I look at something like the square root of x to the power 3, which is an odd number, I always rewrite it as the highest even exponent, which can divide into that number. So because it's 3, I would use 2. Now, if I think about that rule that we just looked at a few minutes ago for even exponents, I'm going to rewrite these as the square root of x to the power 2. I know it's just going to be x, and I've got a square root x left. Let's look at another one. Let's suppose I had x to the power 5. The highest even power, which of course is less than 5, is 4. So I would rewrite it as x to the power 4 with an x left over. This means I would get x to the power 4 times root x, and I know the square root of x to the power 4 has to be 1/2, so this becomes x to the power 2 root x. Now, this rule can be used for any odd exponent. So let's take something much larger. Let's say I had something like x to the power 21. I would rewrite this as x to the power of 20, and I would keep an x outside, so that becomes the square root of x to the power of 20 times the square root of x. And of course, using my exponent law, this, when I take the square root of it, I use 1/2. So this becomes x to the power of 10 root x. So now when we look back up at this definition right here, x to the power of n root x, it should be clear as to why that rule is being used.